To a trauma survivor, it can feel like the whole world has changed. Life in general often seems scarier and more menacing at every turn, because when trauma occurs, the brain changes. In fact, there are three key differences between the brain of someone who suffers from PTSD and the brain of someone who does not, according to Dr. Bessel van der Kolk.
One is that the threat perception system is enhanced, so that people see danger where other people see manageable stuff. Now, this is not in the cognitive part of the brain. This is sort of the core perceptual part, the very primitive part of the brain. So the primitive part of the brain that basically is in charge of making sure that your body is okay becomes a fear-driven brain. So that's number one. Number two is that your filtering system, a little higher up in your brain, that helps you to distinguish between what is relevant right now and what you can dismiss, gets messed up. So things that other people may sort of ignore or not pay attention to, you start paying attention to it, which makes it very hard to focus on what's going on right now. So you get in the whole, you get into the whole issue of being difficult to fully engage with ordinary situations. The third one is that the self-sensing system, which runs through that those midline structures of the brain that various people probably have talked about on your program already, that midline structure that's devoted to your experience of yourself gets blunted. And that's probably a defensive response, because when you are in a state of terror, you feel it in your body. You feel it in terms of heartache and gut-wrenching feelings, and so your body feels bad. And so as a way of coping with that, some people start taking drugs to sort of dampen that system, and other people sort of naturally find a way of dampening that internal response to yourself. But when you start dampening your response to yourself, you also dampen the response to pleasure, sensuality, excitement, connection, stuff like that. So it's very, very deep in the core organism of human beings.
With a deeper understanding of what's happening in the brain following a traumatic experience, we can apply more targeted interventions that can help patients heal